So here we're going to demonstrate how to perform a voltage drop test system. If you recall, voltage drop is one of our best ways to check the connections between the positive battery cable to the starter, the negative to ground, and even across the starter solenoid itself. So we're going to check that out today. One of the best tools to use is a multimeter. Some manuals reference using the AVR or the VAT45, which can be used, but it's really just turning that large bulky tool into a multimeter. So we're going to do this using a multimeter. You're going to want to set your multimeter to volts DC for your starting circuit. You're going to want to make sure that you have the leads in the proper locations, whether it's you're going to want the black lead in COM and the red lead in the volt setting. Let me just reset this. All right, and so our meter is set up. You're welcome to use the auto range feature of the meter. Just know that it might take a few seconds of cranking for that meter to find its proper range, or you could select the range. Keep in mind, we're looking for a low reading, less than half a volt, so we would want to be in some type of that range. I'm going to leave this on auto range for the time being. You're going to take one of the leads. Really doesn't matter whether it's the black or the red lead, and you're going to connect that to the battery. If you would have them reversed, you'll simply see a negative when it gets the voltage drop. Not a big deal. You're looking for the number or the amount of voltage drop to occur. Remember, our goal would be a very low number. A zero voltage drop would be ideal, but normally that's not the case. So we're going to test the positive side of the circuit first. We're going to attach this lead to the positive battery cable as close as we can to the battery terminal. I do recommend using alligator clips, hopefully large ones that will make a good connection. So I'm going to go right on here at the battery post. And the other lead we're going to attach where that positive battery cable terminates. In this case, it's right at the starter solenoid. So we're going to attach that down here to our starter solenoid. Currently, our meter is reading exactly 0 volts. If you remember, voltage drop is only going to occur on an active or energized circuit. So for our starting system, we're only going to see voltage drop when we're cranking. So we will need to crank this engine to be able to get an accurate measurement. Along with that, we want the engine to crank and not start. So we need to disable the fuel system or the engine so it won't start up on us. There's a few different methods that can be used to do that. On some older engines, they may have a manual fuel shutoff or a lever on the side of the injection pump. If you hold that in the shutoff position or leave the cable pulled off, out for the manual fuel shutoff, it'll crank and not start. Another method used on some engines is they might have injector driver fuses. A lot of times on trucks, these might be located near the batteries. So you could pull that injector driver fuse, you'd run into the same situation. You'd have an engine that cranks but will not start. It's just important that you need to make sure that fuse doesn't disconnect the key switch, otherwise it won't even crank for you. One of the more universal ways is to use a remote starter button like we have here. This can be attached directly to the starter solenoid, to the S terminal and positive voltage, and when you would push this button, that engine will crank. Now, keep in mind, there is a huge safety concern with this tool. It is going to turn that engine over no matter what condition the machine is in. So if it's a truck or a piece of equipment, you want to make sure it's in neutral. You want to make sure none of the hydraulics are going to activate. You want to make sure the key is not in the ignition and certainly isn't turned on. Otherwise, that engine could actually start when you press the remote starter button. And our fourth method, which we're actually going to use on this machine, is some engines will have an electrical wire, a fuel solenoid wire, attached usually to the injection pump, and it needs to see positive voltage there to be able to deliver fuel. This machine has that, so we're going to disconnect that wire. You can see that wire right here on top of the injection pump. We're going to unhook that, and we should be able to crank this with the key, and the engine will not start. If the engine does start for any reason, just shut it off right away and determine what went wrong or what else you should be doing to disable it. Remember, you don't want to do anything like closing fuel lines or opening fuel lines because you're going to then either bleed the system of fuel or have liquid fuel leakage on your hands, and that's not a helpful thing either. So we should be all set. We're going to hop up here, crank the engine. During the test, I'm going to try and press the hold button here so we get a static reading, and then we can review what our result was. All right. So here you can see, during our test, the voltage drop occurred as soon as we started cranking. And according to the meter, we have 248, but notice the units, it's very critical. We have 248 millivolts is what our meter read. Millivolts would be 3 decimal places away from a whole volt. So that would be 0.248 volts if we were going to convert it to volts. So we have less than a quarter of a volt, or just about exactly a quarter of a volt. On a piece of equipment or truck, it does depend on the length of the cables and how far they are from the engine. But we're looking for basically 0.4 volts or less for voltage drop on our positive or negative side of the circuit. So this would be within our limits. Now, if this was excessive, we could further begin to pinpoint the source of it by leads. Maybe there's a battery disconnect in the middle that we could connect to and see which part of that circuit is encountering most of the voltage drop. But in this case, we're testing the overall positive side of the circuit, and we're within specifications. We're now going to move our leads and test the negative side. So we're going to take our negative clamp, or our black clamp, and we're going to attach it to the negative battery terminal. Make sure it makes a good connection. And we want to attach where that negative battery cable ends. In this case, there is a ground junction point right here at the base of the starter, where the starter mounts to the engine. It might be on the engine itself, but in this case, it's right on the side of the starter. So we will move this lead. You'll notice that our voltage reads as 0 volts again. We won't encounter voltage drop until we begin cranking. We're still disabled, so we're going to do that next. This is our negative side of the circuit, our ground side. You'll notice that we encountered a greater amount of voltage drop. Not sure if you can see the meter in the video, but we have 350, pay attention to the units, 350 millivolts, which is getting very close to that 0.4 volts limit, or 400 millivolt limit that we talked about. Still within specs, but we have certainly a greater amount of voltage drop here. I would want to pinpoint that further, just determine where that is occurring. Sometimes it could be a dirty battery connection, a damaged cable, and you can determine all of that with voltage drop. The last thing we want to test, or can test with our voltage drop, is the starter solenoid. If you recall, the starter solenoid, when it's energized, makes connection between the two large posts on the solenoid. It should have a very low resistance between them. If the plate in there that makes contact becomes corroded or contaminated in any way, sometimes electric arc causes it to become eaten away, that voltage drop will increase, and it can slow down how fast the engine cranks. So we're going to attach our leads to these two large posts, crank our engine, and measure the voltage drop occurring directly at the solenoid. This type of starter would be very easy to attach to leads. The one we're dealing with is a little different. We're actually going to attach the one back to where we had our positive cable attached for the positive side, right where the positive terminal attaches. And we're then going to go to the other side of the solenoid, where it has a wire coming out of the motor itself. Should be in good shape there. One thing you'll notice, we currently read very close to 12 volts. We read battery voltage right now. That's because before we crank, the positive cable lead obviously is positive, but the part connected to the starter motor has a path to ground. So it's going to read 12 volts. So that's not going to be, we're not looking for our highest reading. We're looking for a reading while we are cranking. That reading will drop significantly lower during cranking. So let's go ahead and do that. All right, so here you can see our voltage drop during the test. It came out as 247 millivolts, a little higher than we want to see. For the solenoid contacts, we're looking for it to be 0.2 volts or less, or 0.3 volts or less to be good contacts, depending on the type of solenoid. So this is getting a little bit on the excessive side. We'd want to look into that just a little further. But this is how you perform voltage drop. You may notice on your job sheet that you might have two blanks on there for positive and negative cables. Some vehicles are equipped with two paths, two cables for the positive or negative side. So that's an opportunity to measure both. But if there's only one cable, one path, then you simply use one of those readings. You're not going to need to record the same reading twice. So hopefully that helps you perform voltage drop. Remember, you're going to be using a normal multimeter, and you're going to be having it set on the volts DC setting.